like to persuade you why it makes sense to investigate deep learning models. In our case, I'll talk about unsupervised segmentation. As a short intro, my name is Piotr Migdał. I do have a PhD in quantum physics, and I work with Bartłomiej Olechno at ECC Games. We use deep learning to create levels and a physics engine for a race game. Additionally, we develop LiveLossPlot, a Python package for charts for deep learning models. When it comes to, I also develop a quantum game in which you are able to play with quantum mechanics in the browser. So before I talk about investigating models interactively, let's make some overview of general how to track our deep learning model training process. So the simplest way is to use console and look what's the log loss, what's accuracy, etc. But I don't think it's a good solution. It's very easy to miss that it gets better or worse. So what to do? So well, the other step is to use TensorBoard or something which tracks metrics. But I think it's much better to save not only metrics, but also all parameters and code snapshots. For example, Neptune, weights and biases, or MLflow. But it's not the only axis with respect to which we can look at model training inspection. The other is depth. So for example, we can only look at some metrics, but I don't think it's enough. Sometimes you can miss that it classifies or misclassifies some obvious examples. So we can always have at least a few examples to see what's going on. But I think it's much better to make interactive. And in a few slides, I'm going to show you how. When it comes to our project, we basically have high resolution scans of racetracks. And we want to turn them into semantic maps. It's not enough data to use supervised representation. They're very diverse, but we can use something like Word2Vec to look at adjacent locations. And it's enough, but we want to make sure that we are able to extract relevant data. It's a simple example of the scan, but also t-SNE of feature maps, not of the original pixels. The question is if we can extract, for example, tire tracks or cracks on the road or anything. And let me talk about the pipeline. Well, basically training PyTorch, in this case plus Ignite. We save models with LiveLossPlot plus Neptune and all metrics, but also we out of feature maps we create some visualizations using D3, and as you see right now I present them in a slide. In this case it's IO slides. When you write things, even for internal nodes, we use distill for R Markdown. And here's an example. This is a picture, but when we mouse over, we see what are the relevant pixels or types. And not only we can look at similar pictures we expect to one place, but also we can look at the differences. For example, this one versus the other. There's a river, there's some buildings near the river, and there's a forest. In this case, we can see what's going on. Also, we can look at the places which do not work correctly. But also we can use, game data. In this case, it's SimCity, the classic one, the original SimCity. There's some buildings, and sometimes even we can separate, residential area from industrial area. Or we can look at another games like Minesweeper and compare models. So you see, it's like we want to have something that tells us which region is inside and which is outside. This model, shows something, but I think it's not perfect. And this one is, I think, much better, because at the same time, you can separate inside from the outside. Also see, they are different, and here they are different. Maybe you can look at the difference. Yes, it's very remarkable. And the thing is, it's not that easy to not that hard to include that. In my remark, that basically is a few lines. The only thing is to write a simple visualization in D3 and also include JSON, so we need to export things to JSON. But I think JSON is not that good format for serializing matrices and arrays. It's costly, it's slow, it's not type safe. So I think it'd be nice to have and use a general standardized format for with input and output of matrices. It's crucial not only for deep learning, but also for quantum computing. It's basically the same story, just you need to have complex numbers to describe all your data. So, well, that's all. There are some inspirations. And also, especially, I invite you to look at the collaborative list of machine learning, deep learning, and statistics websites. A lot of expert explanations. And, well, you can also check our open source projects, this Libelos plot and the quantum game. Have a nice day.